live my life like that. Last year, I didn't take anything till the end of the year, and I suffered at the top of the year. January, February, March, I need a little sunshine.
Don't you feel good now?
I feel great. Got we went that? To Orlando, and a little parenting hack is that we definitely lied to our child.
You're not the only. She loved Disney.
And she loved what she thought was Disney.
Yeah. If you follow Marianne, you can see all the places that weren't Disney there.
Or Epcot.
Yeah, that you may have gone to.
Can we share one or two of those videos on our Facebook?
Yeah, I'll put some of them on there.
Beauty.
So you could see what I did. But yeah, I guess I'll fill you in. We had a couple of mishaps that threatened to make the vacation horrible.
That's what we recovered.
Right. And I'll tell you the thing that Dahlia was most excited about. And the answer will surprise you. Oh, yeah. Back from Orlando.
Tan, rested, and ready.
That's true.
You and Nixon.
Everybody was coughing on the flight, made me a little paranoid about coronavirus.
Why? What were they coughing about?
It was like a symphony. I actually should have recorded some audio from it. It was just dry cough here, dry cough there. A lot of kids. And a few masks, not a ton of coronavirus masks. A
couple of pictures of stars with the masks on. Kate Hudson had a paper mask, but Gwyneth had a really... It looked high tech. It had little breathing apparatus on the side.
Oh, like a respirator.
Yeah, it was black. But they're not sure if those masks even help.
Yeah, my sister just bought some respirators. We're going to talk about that coming up later, too.
Hey, real quick, somebody said the mic on LiveWire is in my face, so I should put it on this side. Let's try that for a little while.
Okay.
See how that works. How's that look, listener? Can you see me better now?
Okay, Aaron. So I was on the flight. First time Dolly was on a flight. So we thought, put her by the window and she'll get to see the liftoff and really enjoy it.
That's good.
And as we were taking off, she said, it's like magic. And we're like, I know, right?
Yeah.
She was talking about the armrest.
Oh, the armrest is like magic.
Because it went up and down.
Yeah.
And that really, we're like, but look outside the window.
Yeah.
There's some more magic happening.
A lot more magic.
We're in the air. And she did not care.
Mm.
But she really loved that armrest.
That's okay. They miss it right. It's frustrating to the parent because you're showing.
I mean, it was
you're
just
lifting
funny.
Off. You're lifting off.
This is supposed to be the thing that you care about.
Not to invade your story, but we took my son to the circus and he played with the chair the whole time.
Yeah.
Because it was one of those chairs, you know, out of the arena. As soon as you get up, the chair goes back up.
It's pretty amazing.
He thought that was all that and didn't even look. He was looking at the chair the whole time.
I know.
Same sort of thing.
Yeah.
But.
It's like the joke of get your kid a cardboard box. That's what they're, you know, they'll take the toy out and play with the box. So.
Right.
It was actually a good lesson for us to not bother with Disney, which everybody told us you have to go. She's four. She's going to be four in a little bit. So this is a good age for her. But the things that she loved had nothing to do with an $8,000 trip to Disney. So we didn't go to Disney.
Hell no. It's too early. She's too early for that.
Well, I mean, Disney, I think, is great for all different age groups up until you're about, you know, you're older. But we didn't go. We gave her a choice. We said, you can go to Legoland for the day.
Right.
Or we'll do this character dinner and you'll meet Snow White and the Queen. And hands down, she wanted to meet Snow White and the Queen. So we did that.
There you go.
But looking at how tired she got just walking around the pools and stuff, I can't imagine taking her to Disney for the day.
She'd crash out at night.
My God, by noon. So the other thing she loved was watching TV in a hotel. Because we don't really do that a lot. So she had a TV in her. She had her own room, and she had a TV in her room.
See you on Wednesday when
no
we leave.
No joke. That was all she wanted to do. We had to force her to come go to the pools.
Damn.
She's like, maybe one more show. I'll just watch a show because that was like her big treat. I mean, it's just hilarious what in actuality they love.
Todd Marinovich. I'll tell you the story of Todd Marinovich. His father, Marv, wouldn't let Todd eat Big Macs or Snickers bars. And Todd was a good athlete. He was a quarterback at USC and then drafted by the Raiders, was a quarterback for a while.
30 on 30.
Then he went nuts.
Yeah.
Yeah, Todd, good guy, but
listen,
spiraled.
No one's saying no.
No.
We're giving options and noticing what she is choosing.
Right.
And then not pushing the topic. If I had spent $1 million, I would have been pushing Disney, but we didn't.
Right.
So we, you know, sort of gently, we drove around the hotel. I don't know. It was fine. But when we got there, my luggage, apparently, I thought luggage had to be 50 pounds. I thought that was the limit.
They'll put a heavy on there if it's 50 or up, or sometimes 45, but if you get to 50, you got to pay extra dough.
Apparently, with Spirit, you have to pay extra if it's over 40.
Oh, yeah, Spirit.
Oh, God.
If you got pants on, you got to pay extra.
I'm not joking.
Yeah.
Everything was an extra fee, so we got there. My luggage was 48 pounds. We put all of it in one.
Right.
So we pay. We tried to take things out and carry it. I'm like, this is ridiculous.
Doesn't that suck? That fire
$30.
Drill.
So 60 total.
That's a, yeah, I mean, anyway.
All right. Exactly. That's at that point, we're like, fine, just do it.
Right.
Put my credit card in, paid, left the credit card there, y'all.
Oh,
yeah.
No.
Left the credit card in the machine.
Oh.
First day of vacation. Didn't know it until I got to the credit card, to the car rental place. And she goes, okay, you're going to refuse insurance. Can I have your credit card? And I'm like, no problem.
Yeah.
Oh.
Honey.
Yeah.
Damn.
So Robbie had one. No, it's under your name. So we need your credit card. I have a debit card. Then you have to buy the $90 insurance a day or whatever it was.
Hey, they're getting you. Catch it up.
So, yeah. So I had to pay. I'm telling you, our car rental was as much as the flight because we had to pay for so many extra things
because
my credit card was in the machine.
What's happening here?
When I looked on the bank slip, somebody charged $100 with my credit card to Spirit. So we had to cancel that.
Yeah, that was quick. They got right on it.
They must have seen it in the machine and just went, buy my luggage or whatever they did. I don't know.
Yeah, that's what they did.
So they canceled the card. It was all fine. But
this is day one.
This was not even day. Like, we arrived. So paid extra for luggage, extra for the car. Then we're trying to find somewhere to eat. You know,
I'm getting drinks. I'm getting a couple drinks after that.
So we're Googling restaurants. You know, you're starving, right?
Dagnabbit.
Couldn't find anything. Finally found like a Wawa. Went in there and ate just gross stuff.
Get a hoagie.
Whatever it was.
Right.
Dry things that were horrible. We leave to go to the hotel. Then the next turn we take, restaurants everywhere. I mean, McDonald's, Wendy's, sit down places. It's like we were moments away from Shangri-La. So we get to the hotel. I want to tell you this real quick. They're like, okay, you're all paid, but there is a resort fee.
Yes, they hit you with that resort fee.
Resort fees are such BS.
It is.
And I think I knew about it. I saw there was a woman suing.
There's a thing on TV.
Yeah.
She's suing.
Yes. Because she's saying it should be at least there. It is in the fine print.
How much is that?
$30 extra a day.
A day.
A day.
Get your resort on.
Oh, and there's parking. 19 a day.
A day.
So at that point, I'm just laughing. I'm like, great. Mm. And then, you start to get paranoid at that point. Like, where else is a fee? If we go in the pool, is there a fee to get out?
I used to hate seeing the guy. There's always a guy standing around and wants to help you with something.
No, yeah, no.
So you can, I got it.
We were paranoid. We had all our luggage. I'm like, don't touch me. Don't even look at me.
The guy starts wheeling over the cart. No.
Yeah, I don't want to pay anymore.
You're right. You're so right.
We just bled money
the
moment we got off the thing. And honestly, if they had charged us to use the pool, I would have just slept in the pool. I would have just been like, we're floating here for the night because I can't take it. But after that, it was smooth sailing. It was just a very bumpy first night.
And you can count on that no matter what your vacation is going to be.
And whatever you do, don't tally what you spent. Just don't do it. Do not get a final toll on what you spent. You're going to just be depressed.
You got to do it. You did it. You had a good time.
I did. I'm not looking at the bill.
Hey, you got a couple of people on the phone. Gary, what's up, Gary?
Hey, I was listening to Marianne talk about her daughter on the plane. Recently, I was on a plane leaving BWI, and as we were going down the runway, there was a woman and her young daughter looked to be maybe 3 or 4 years old sitting at the window seat. And she's looking out, and she's going, mommy's going, well, what do you think about this? It's pretty cool, isn't it? She goes, yeah. How do I put the window down?
Right. That's something you're going to learn. I love those questions.
Thanks, Gary.
I love, hearing what kids, with their perspective of it.
You put the window down, this whole plane's going down. Augie doggy. Is this Augie?
Hey, what's going on, fellas? Hey, guys, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, that's
how you
okay.
doing today?
We're good. What's
I'm
going
good.
On with you, Augie?
I got my Disney story, man. First, those lines are ridiculous. But anyway, yeah. Marianne, I hear you. Took the kids a bunch of years ago, so I bought 6 days in a row at Disney. Saved a couple dollars.
Yep.
By day three, the kids like, do we have to go?
Right. Yes, you do. Yes.
Do we have to go?
Oh,
really?
We have to
it's
go.
Damn.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I got that sense that Dahlia would have been done. You know, like she was done it. With the pools.
Hey. Yeah, they love that TV. You know? Hey.
I know, right?
Enjoyed that. Real quick. We got to go.
So funny.
Augie, how was the bargain on the 5 or 6 day thing?
Oh, it was pretty cool. We had a good time, but the kids just, you know, they weren't into all that.
It's
they got tired.
Expensive, though, right?
No, you know what? We actually put a trip together. Somebody I knew took care of our room for us. Got pretty cheap. I put together way less than a travel agent.
Wow.
Oh, with,
you can do
okay.
It, if you do a little bit of work, you can yes. put it together pretty cheap.
Yes.
All right, Augie.
All right, guys. Take care.
See you, buddy. Thanks
there
for listening.
There are full-on Disney concierges, Kirk.
Yeah.
Like people whose business it is to plan your trip and give you all the, you know, we drove around the campus of it. I don't even know what you call it. The world.
That's about right. It's a campus.
And we saw a lot of the hotels and we're like, okay, maybe next time I'll go there. You know, it was kind of cool to scout it out, but there was so many options. You just start going cross-eyed.
Yeah. My son, he is definitely on the warpath. He's like, so.
Really?
What's up with Disney?
What I keep hearing
hey,
about
this. Yeah. I mean, how about this summer? You know.
Really?
Can't wait to go to Orlando. You know, we go to Orlando every summer.
Actually, he is a great age for it though.
Yeah. He's about ready. Dang, I need to hit the lotto or something. It's,
like
or get
said,
Augie to book my
plan
trip.
It, yeah. Yeah, it's
all
good
right.
times.
Welcome back. There are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com, the 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android, and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.